हु इज गिविंग आंसर?
मैम रेणुका
गिव द
लाइक द वाइटल फोर्स इट इज नॉट विजिबल. हाँ मैम, लाइक द वाइटल फोर्स इट इज नॉट विजिबल बट द इफेक्ट ऑफ वाइटल फोर्स इज ऑब्जर्व. सिमिलरली एग्जाम्पल इज गिवन बाय हनीमन मून एंड अर्थ. We cannot observe its revolution, but effect of this revolution can be observed. Example of measles and chickenpox is given. When there is person with chickenpox, it spread only chickenpox, not a measles. And same of medicine. Medicine of one disease cannot show other disease symptom. That is action of that medicine is dominant. Another example of hand raise is given. When we travel through car or buses, then there is accidental brake. Then we try to hold something, and result will more. And also given that when we give the medicine of high dynamicity, but their dose is small. And, but its action is more due to its potentization because its power of increases due to potentization.
Correct. Okay, nice try. Anyone else? Anyone else wants to try? Nobody. Okay. So we will move forward. Aphorism number 12. In the morbidly affected, vital energy alone that produce disease, so that the morbid phenomena perceptible to our senses express at a time all the internal change, that is to say, the whole morbid derangement of the internal dynamics. In a word, they reveal the whole disease. So when this vital energy, which is dynamic in nature, when it is get deranged, it is shown to our senses by the morbid phenomena. It is perceptible to our senses by this morbid phenomena. And that morbid phenomena is nothing but the disease. This morbid phenomena is nothing but the morbid derangement of the vital force, that is the dynamic in nature. And it will reveal in front of you in the form of signs and symptoms of the disease, because signs and symptoms are the language of the disease. Consequently, also the disappearance under the treatment of all morbid phenomena and all the morbid alterations that differ from healthy vital operations. So, if you want to treat that morbid phenomena, if you want to alter the morbid phenomena and retain that healthy vital operations, what we have to do? We have to maintain the integrity. We have to restore the integrity, not maintain, but we have to restore the integrity of that vital force. And then only the health will be recovered of the whole organism. So what is given in the 12th aphorism? This vital energy is the only thing which is required for, or which is responsible for producing the disease. When this vital energy or the vital force is get deranged, it is perceptible to our senses by the morbid phenomena. This morbid phenomena is nothing but the morbid derangement of the internal dynamic vital force, and it is revealed in the form of disease. If you want to treat that morbid phenomena, if you want to alter the morbid alterations which are from healthy to disease state, then we have to first restore the integrity of the vital force, and then only our health will be recovered. Clear?
Yes ma'am.
Yes ma'am.
Now again there is a footnote for the word disease. That is, a one mark is here for the word disease. So what is disease? Now again he explained how the vital force causes the organism to display morbid phenomena. Now from the aphorism we know that there is a morbid derangement of vital force, but that vital force will derange, ye humko kaise pata chalega? When he produces disease. It would be, ये मैंने गलती से पढ़ा था तब कि how the disease is produced, it is of no use. It is not a practical utility. सिर्फ आपको ध्यान क्या रखना है? The language of the disease or the signs and symptoms. That signs and symptoms only sufficient for us to cure the patient. So that our Lord of life will be restored again. It will be revealed back again with our and it will be and we will feel comfortness through our senses. So this is our duty, okay, to restore that vital force, restore the health again, maintain the integrity of that Lord of life, so that the patient feels better. To find out the cause, to find out the dynamicity of the vital force, the dynamic agent, that is no practical utility. पेशेंट आपके चेंबर में सिम्टम्स लेके आएगा, यू विल आस्क इफ इट इज एक्यूट केस, यू विल आस्क हिम कि क्या खाया था, ठंडे पानी में भीगे थे क्या, या फिर बाहर का कुछ खाया, या घर में ही कुछ आधा अधूरा, या फिर हाफ फ्राइड, या फिर हाफ कुक ऐसा कुछ खाना खाया. सो वॉट एवर द रीजन यू आर आस्किंग, आपने उसको आपको एक अप्रोक्सीमेट रीजन मिल गया है. हाउ दैट रीजन अफेक्ट्स योर वाइटल फोर्स, देर इज नो प्रैक्टिकल यूटिलिटी. नाउ यू नो कि देर इज अ सम डिरेंजमेंट ऑफ द वाइटल फोर्स, वॉट यू विल डू, वॉट इज योर ड्यूटी, यू हैव टू कलेक्ट द पिक्यूलियर सिम्टम्स ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर डिसीज. दैट इज ओनली सफिशियंट फॉर यू. That is only a sufficient to cure that patient, so that that Lord of life will restore again, and ultimately the health will be restored. If that patient gives you the five symptoms, among that you have to take the characteristic symptom, two or three characteristic symptom, and depending upon that uncommon and the characteristic symptom, you have to give the medicine. This is your duty. It is not our duty. This is not our practical utility. Ki where is that vital force? Why it is dynamic, why we are doing potentization, we know, but when you are sitting in your OPD, you only want the symptoms and a similar medicine, nothing else. Clear?
Yes ma'am.
So what is given in the 12th?
Yes ma'am.
How the disease is produced by this dynamic nature of the vital force, and what you have to note down to treat that vital force. This much given in the aphorism number 12. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, ma'am. The aphorism number 13. Can anybody read for me aphorism number 13?
Ma'am, may I?
Mention Ikra. Hello?
Ma'am, me. Therefore, disease as considered as it by the allopathist as a thing separate from the living whole, from the organism and its animating vital force, and hidden in the interior, but it ever so subtle a character is an absurdity that could only be imagined by minds of materialistic stem, and has for thousands of years given to the prevailing system of medicine all those pernicious impulses that have made it truly mischievous non-healing art.
Mischievous non-healing art. Okay, thank you, Kunal. So this, therefore, the disease, now we know the vital force, the qualities of vital force, we know the dynamic nature of the vital force. To treat that dynamic nature, we have to give the potentized medicines. when that vital force is deranged, how could you know okay, that vital force is deranged? All these things we have seen from the aphorism number 9 to 12. How it reveals ki vital force is deranged through the signs and symptoms. So this is our view to treat the patient. We only want the uncommon symptom. We are not running behind the nature of that vital force. We are not running behind the dynamic nature of that morbid affection. Jo causes hai, wo bhi dynamic hai. Aur vital force jo hai, wo bhi dynamic hai. Toh medicine bhi humko dynamic hi deni hai. Cause dynamic, vital force dynamic, medicine dynamic. Ye humko pata hai. We are believing all these things. We are not running behind. Aur na hum usme zyada apna dimag laga rahe ki how it is dynamic, prove it. We are accepting the truth. And what we required practically, we only require the uncommon symptoms. We only require the characteristic symptom. In the OPD, we will take out the characteristic symptom from the patient and we will give the medicine. Just we have done in the totality of the symptom. I have given you a one case. Aapko hi maine di thi na ye case ek. And in that, you have to differentiate common and the uncommon symptoms.
Yes ma'am.
हाँ, so आपने वही आपको yes, ओपीडी में बैठ के करना है. You just have to differ. ये कॉमन सिम्टम्स है एक्स वाई जेड. हाँ, तो डायग्नोसिस ये हिमोराइड्स होगा या डायग्नोसिस ये फारेंजाइटिस होगा, लैरिंजाइटिस होगा या क्रॉन्स डिसीज होगा. Not required. What we required? Characteristic symptoms. The patient wants the cold water in the winter season. The patient is having the pain, that boring type of pain. He want to tight bandage around the head or whatever the uncommon. या फिर जो disease में नहीं है वो सिर्फ वो particular patient में ही ये कुछ symptoms है. वही symptoms हम लेंगे and we will prescribe the medicine. This is our duty. This is a very clearly mentioned in these aphorisms by Dr. Hanuman. We are not running behind that cause of the disease. If you know the exciting cause, it is very good. If you don't know the exciting cause, let it be. Try to collect the uncommon symptom. So we are having the different ways how to collect the red line symptoms, peculiar symptom, characteristic symptoms that we will study in the case taking. But the problem arises when we are discussing our pathy with the old school, because they want the material cause for the disease. They want to know the cause by their name. Staphylococcus hai, streptococcus hai, varicella bacteria hai, sorry, varicella hai, varicella zoster hai, ya herpes virus hai, herpes simplex hai, ya fir salmonella hai, सेल्मोनेला फैमिली में से है या फिर कौन सा पैरासाइट है, कौन सा वायरस है, फ्रॉम विच फैमिली दे बिलोंग. सो दे वांट ऑल दिस डिटेलिंग बिकॉज दे कंसिडर द मटेरियल थिंग एज अ कॉज ऑफ द डिजीज, बिकॉज दे कंसिडर द पैथोजेंस और द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म एज अ कॉज ऑफ द डिजीज. वाई दे आर कंसिडरिंग दिस? बिकॉज विद द हेल्प ऑफ माइक्रोस्कोप, इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप एंड मच मोर एडवांस माइक्रोस्कोप, they are able to see that small tiny creatures ki they are causing the infection in our body. But our path is beyond that theory. Hum aur uske aage ka sochte hain. We are thinking that these small creatures, these tiny creatures, they are causing the infection. Yes, you are right, we are not neglecting that, but why they are causing infection? ऐसा क्या होता है बॉडी में कि दे आर एक्टिंग? बिकॉज इन अवर इंटेस्टाइन सो मेनी बैक्टीरियाज आर प्रेजेंट, इन अवर थ्रोट सो मेनी बैक्टीरियाज आर प्रेजेंट, द एयर इन विच वी आर रिस्पायरिंग सो मेनी वायरसेस एंड बैक्टीरियाज आर प्रेजेंट, वी आर ईटिंग ड्रिंकिंग इन दैट ऑल्सो फूड एंड इन वॉटर बैक्टीरियाज एंड वायरसेस आर प्रेजेंट. बट वाई एवरी टाइम वी आर नॉट फॉलिंग इल? वाई ओनली ऑन द पर्टिकुलर टाइम वी फॉल इल? Why only that particular time we are having the signs and symptoms? So we think beyond that. हम उनके आगे का सोचते हैं कि susceptibility decrease होती है. We are more susceptible to the infectious agent क्योंकि हमारी body हमको साथ नहीं दे रही है, क्योंकि हमारे vital force deranged हो गया है. Immunity is decreases and that's why that small tiny creatures are acting on our body. So the first cause is the derangement of the vital force, or the vital force deranged ho gaya hai, so immunity low ho gayi hai, and that's why that tiny creatures are now got the opportunity to act on our body. Isliye wo bechare microorganisms hum pe, if your immunity is strong, so vital force bhi aapka strong hai, तो वो बैक्टीरिया वो वायरसेस हम पे एक्ट नहीं करेंगे. नाउअडेज आल्सो दोज आर वर्किंग इन द हॉस्पिटल्स अमंग यू पीपल. बहुत सारे बच्चे अभी हॉस्पिटल में जॉब कर रहे होंगे आप में से ही, या फिर एटलीस्ट वो असिस्टेंट करके भी जा रहे होंगे. सो दे नो कि जिसकी इम्यूनिटी लो है तो वो पेशेंट को कोविड बहुत जल्दी हो रहा है, या जिसकी इम्यूनिटी अच्छी है दे आर अंडर द माइल्ड केसेस या दे आर अंडर द असिम्प्टोमेटिक पेशेंट. सो वी आर कीपिंग देम इन द आइसोलेशन. बट देयर इम्यूनिटी इज लो और दे आर हैविंग द कोमॉर्बिडिटी, यानी उनको हाइपरटेंशन है, डायबिटीज है, थायराइड है. सो दे आर अंडर द कोमॉर्बिड कंडीशन एंड दे वॉन्ट ऑक्सीजन, दे वॉन्ट द वेंटिलेशन, दे वॉन्ट द पैसिव रेस्पिरेशन. सो इन दिस वे सो दिस टाइनी क्रिएचर दे आर एक्टिंग मोर फास्टली ऑन द कोमॉर्बिड पेशेंट एज कम्पेयर टू द दोज आर हैविंग द स्ट्रांग इम्यूनिटी. So their body is fighting. That's why they are having the mild or they are having the asymptomatic patient that we are called. So we are not neglecting that material cause, but we are keeping that material cause as the ultimate cause. Usko humne last mein rakha hai. Our approximate cause is derangement of vital force, lower susceptibility. That's why these tiny creatures are acting, and that's why we are having the signs and symptoms. So our approximate cause is derangement. Ultimate cause is tiny creatures or the material cause. So our journey of the disease start from the immaterial thing and it ends also with the immaterial things, because you are doing the potentization with your medicine. So dynamic and dynamic, like begets like, similia similibus curantur. So this is our thinking. Now what the allopaths are think, this is given in the aphorism number 13. Therefore, the disease considered as by the allopath. So he clearly mentioned here that this is their view in the aphorism number 13. As a thing separate from a living whole, from the organism, its animating vital force, and hidden in the interior, be it ever so subtle character, is an absurdity. यानि जो vital force है, it animate our body. वो कहीं तो भी cells में है, कहीं तो भी tissues में है. It is having a subtle character. Subtle character means again a dynamic. वो अपना काम passively कर रहा है. Absurdity में है वो, that you cannot see it. जैसे hide and seek हम लोग खेलते हैं ना, so it is in a hidden part में है वो. You only imagine it by your mind. लेकिन materialistic stamp अगर आपके दिमाग में है, if you want to prove, if you want to see that vital force, then you will never believe the concept of vital force. इसीलिए materialistic stamp allopath वालों का है, and that's why they are not accepting our doctrine of vital force. Thousands of years बीत गए हैं, but they are not accepting our pathy, they are not accepting our concept, and hence their system, उनके system को उन्होंने, they are accepting the material cause of the disease, they are giving the medicine in that way, and hence the Hahnemann said that कि their system is pernicious, their system is dangerous, and they are playing mischievous non-healing art. Mischievous means which is not good, which is truly mischievous, not only mischievous, it is truly mischievous. यानी सही में they are the dangerous to the life of the patient, which is not healing, which is not helping to the patient because of the different reasons. So this is given the allopathic point of view of disease. So what is their point? They say that कि the material cause is the cause of the disease, and they are giving the medicine accordingly. But this type of practice is a mischievous non-healing art. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
What is our concept? What is our view? And what is the old school view? Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So we will stop here today, and tomorrow we will start from the aphorism number 14. Any doubt in the aphorism number 11, 12 and 13? Anyone? Our view towards the disease for the treatment, it is given for the disease, for the vital force, and for the treatment. And their views for the vital force, for the disease, and for the treatment. Is it clear? All these three points? These three points yes, are only explained in these yes, efforts. Yes, are you able to write down these three points by taking the reference from 11, 12, and 13?
Yes, ma'am.
Only yes, one yes?
Ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, then send it to
yes,
me.
Ma'am.
Write down on your paper from aphorism number 11, 12, and 13, the explanation of these three aphorisms. Try. I'm not saying ki you are aap ekdam perfectionist ho aur pura aapka sahi aayega. At least try to write down the some features on the dynamic by giving the example. What is the view of allopathy for that vital force and how they are treating the patient and how we are treating the patient. Are you able to write down these three aphorisms?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay,
yes,
write
ma'am.
Down yes, and ma'am. Send it to me.
Okay, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Again,
yes,
tomorrow ma'am. We will discuss all okay, these ma'am. Things. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. And if you have any doubt, you can ask me right now or you can ask me while you are writing. Because when you want to write, at that time, aapko samjhega ki kaise likhe, kya doubt aa raha hai, iska meaning nahi samajh raha hai. At that time also you can ask me. Clear?
Okay, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So we will stop here today and tomorrow we will take aphorism number 14 plus revision of the previous aphorisms. Okay?
Ma'am, there is a lecture.
Huh?
Ma'am, maja network jate madhi madhi.
Huh? Mug? I am sharing the link also na on the YouTube. Theek hai. So tomorrow we will meet again. Time I will give it to you. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. So write down all these things and send it to me on WhatsApp. Okay, I am ending this meeting here. If you have any doubt, you can ask. Or you can ask me on the WhatsApp or in group or personal, anyway, no problem. Okay.